Hello everyone and welcome to the introduction video for my GSOAP 2020 project CAPE compatibility layer for BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. My mentors for this project are Jason Kreidner, Drew Fustini, Yunia Yao and Kumar Abhishek. Before talking about the project itself, let me introduce myself. My name is Deepak Khatri and I am currently a 4th year biotechnology undergraduate student from Netaji Subhash University of Technology, New Delhi, India. My interests include electronics, computer science, bioinformatics, and physics. And over this summer, I will be working on the CAPE compatibility layer for BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI project under BeagleBone.org. Let's talk about BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. They are both mechanically, as in hardware form factor, and pin header compatible, as they both provide similar set of peripherals over their P8 and P9 expansion headers. And my project will explore those functionalities to create a CAPE compatibility layer. But what is a CAPE compatibility layer anyway? The idea of this project is to make the same user space code work with both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI using the same references to drivers for peripherals assigned to the same header pins between BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. Also to make the same device tree overlay work for both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. For CAPEs, U-Boot CAPE Manager will also be updated to support BeagleBone AI so that device tree overlays will be automatically loaded during boot. My goals for this project include creating header pin references for BeagleBone AI that matches with BeagleBone Black, assigning same symlinks for buses like I2C, SPI, UART, CAN bus, etc. We'll see an example on the next slide. Cleaning up code in Beagle Tester and creating new examples. Making same user space examples work with both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI and testing the pin control using libgpiod. Creating U-Boot device tree overlays for BeagleBone AI board buses and CAPEs because only boot time pin muxing is available on the AM5729 processor of BeagleBone AI. I will also set up the U-Boot BeagleBone CAPE Manager to load BeagleBone AI device tree overlays for CAPEs just like we have for BeagleBone Black. Here we can see an example of a symlink created using device tree overlay and a UDEV rule. The I2C1 of BeagleBone Black and I2C5 of BeagleBone AI are attached to same bone I2C1 on both the boards and can be accessed through same header pins. Here is an example of symlinks assigned for buses in device tree. For both the devices, symlinks bone/UART/0 is defined, which is nothing but UART0 of BeagleBone Black and UART1 of BeagleBone AI. Here is a UDEV rule that creates the CSFS entries and also the aliases in /dev. The first part in yellow tells us if there is a symlink attribute defined in the device tree node, then set a device property value to that symlink, basically creating a key value pair. The second part tells us if there is a symlink value obtained from the device tree and there is a device node in the /dev, create a sysfs node that is in /sys corresponding to that symlink we got from device tree. Also, create an additional alias name to the device unit in /dev. Here is the internal working of CAPE Manager and how it loads the device tree overlay for the CAPEs. When we insert the CAPE on a BeagleBone Black and boot the board, U-Boot detects the CAPE through information provided by CAPE's onboard EEPROM. The CAPE Manager looks for a compatible device tree overlay. The CAPE Manager then loads the compatible device tree overlay. And at the end, the device drivers for all the onboard CAPE devices are loaded and the CAPE is working. Successful completion of this project provides these benefits. This project will make transition to BeagleBone AI and future BeagleBones easier for BeagleBone Black users. Users will be able to easily use BeagleBone Black CAPEs with BeagleBone AI. Making user space examples written for BeagleBone Black work with BeagleBone AI will help save a lot of time for developers. Also, future work will be easier to port from BeagleBone Black to BeagleBone AI and vice versa. This project will allow users to create single device tree overlay to work on both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. Thank you so much for attending this presentation. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to check out the description box for more information. Peace.